Very good morning to one and all. So children, after completing very first chapter of physics, that is motion, now we are going to start second chapter, that is according to the science book, that is chapter number 9, force and laws of motion, right? So children, whenever we are talking about the force, force plays a very important role in our day-to-day life. That means whenever we are just doing some moving activities, right? Moving activities. So every time we have to push, we have to pull something, then sometimes we change the state of object. Sometimes we want to change the position of the object. For those purposes, every time we apply some push or pull on the object. Right? So children, in this particular scenario, what are the effects of push and pull whenever we apply this on an object? Right? So when we apply a push or pull on an object, that means in that condition, any of the object tries to change its position, its shape, or its state. Right? But sometimes it's not. Right? For example, if we want to push a wall, so we are not able to push a wall, but we try to push a wall. But if we push any book that placed on a table, then by applying a push, we are able to move that book from one position to the another position, right? That's why every time whenever we apply a push or pull on an object, it tries to change the position of the object, but every time it is not possible to change the state or position of the object, right? So from there we got the definition: whenever we are just applying a push or pull on an object, then it tends to change means it's trying to change the position, the configuration or state or size of an object, right? And this is known as force. Then, so that is the combined effect of push or pull on an object, right? So force, if you define force, it is a push or pull which tends to change, or you can write down, try to change the position, shape, state of an object. Right? So every time, remember that this is not possible. Every time you are just applying the force on the object, and every time object will change its position, but it tries to change. But whenever you apply a push or pull on the object, that push or pull try to change the position of the object. Right? Now, for the example, if you just move to the example of the force can move the stationary object. Similar, or right now we are just using the term can. Then, so that is the possibility. That shows the possibility. That means force can move the stationary body. Can move. It can be. But every time it is not possible. Second, force can stop a moving object, or force can stop the moving object also. Right? So this is the complete definition of the force. So whenever, anytime you are just defining the definition of the force, always remember, it is not only a push or pull. It is not only a push or pull. It is a push or pull which try to change, which tends to change the position, state or size of an object. Sometimes it can change and sometimes it cannot. Right? Now, whenever we are talking about the force, in according to the forces, there are two types of the force. Basically, we study in the class 9th only. That is, one is the unbalanced force. So what is balanced force and what is unbalanced force? क्या होते हैं balanced force और unbalanced force? Basically, whenever, that is the simple example of the tug of war, we are having a, we just play this game. Basically, हम ये गेम प्ले करते हैं. तो there are the two situations of tug of war. One time, what happens? When two teams are on the opposite side and they just apply the force, so any of the team is not able to move that rope, right? तो आप जब दोनों teams force apply करती हैं दोनों side से, तो कोई भी team एक condition में क्या होता है, कोई भी team उस rope को move नहीं कर पाती. That means rope will not move to the left side or to the right side. That will be stationary on its position, right? And what is the second situation? Second situation is that when one team is able to move the rope to their side, right? So, एक condition में क्या होता है, दूसरी condition में क्या होता है कि एक team जो होती है, one team that applies the move force, and that team is able to move the rope to their side. और वो क्या करते हैं, उस greater force की help से अपनी जो rope होती है, उसको अपनी side move करने में able होते हैं. Then, and that team will be the winning team and second team will be the losing team, right? Now, these are the two situations of the balanced force and the unbalanced force. So, balanced force, if the resultant of applied force is zero. So, how will you understand what is the resultant force? When you applied a same amount of the force from the both side of the rope, that is the balanced force. In that situation, net amount of the force will be equals to zero, right? That means in tug of war, what happens if you apply the force of 300 newton to the left side and 300 newton to the right side, right? So both side amount of the forces will be equal, right? So their net effect will be equals to zero, right? Whenever you will just calculate it, their net effect will be equals to zero, right? Now, what is balanced force? Unbalanced force, if the resultant of the applied force are greater than the zero. That means, if the resultant of the applied force is not equal to zero and it is greater than the zero. That means, जब भी आप force apply कर रहे हैं, तो वो दोनों तरफ से बराबर, both sides से equal amount of force ना apply होकर के, one side the amount of the force is the greater and one side amount of the force is the lesser. Because जब दोनों side equal होगा तो rope will not move. But अगर एक side ज़्यादा force apply होगा, second side, left side या right side में से किसी भी side में, if the amount of the force is greater, then in only that condition you are able to move the rope, right? So for that example, what happens? One side we are just applying the force of the 300 newton, and one side we are just applying the force of the 400 newton. So when you equate these two situations, so you will not get the zero value of the net force. You will get some amount of the force that will be greater than the zero, right? So these are the two types of the forces, balanced force and unbalanced force. And to just easy recall of these two types, just only remember the conditions of the example of the that game tug of war, right? So these are the two types of the forces, balanced force and unbalanced force. When from the both side equal amount of the force is applied, then, or we can say in the technical language, we can say net force is equals to zero, then that is the balanced force. And when net force is not equals to zero, it is greater than the zero, then that is the situation of the unbalanced force, right, children? Now there are some effects of the balanced force and unbalanced force, right? Now there are some effects of the balanced force and unbalanced force. Balanced force cannot change the state of rest or change the state of motion. That means if we are just applying the balance force on any of the object and on in any of the situation, so that balance force is not able to change the position of that object. That means if object is in motion, that will be continue in motion, and if object is at rest, that will be in the rest condition, right? So balance force cannot change the state of rest or state of of motion, just for the example of the tug of war. Whenever we are just applying the force of the balance force, that rope will not able to move. ना जब भी हम उसमें बैलेंस फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे थे तो वो रूप एबल नहीं हो रही थी मूव करने में, दैट विल बी स्टेशनरी एट इट्स पोजिशन, राइट. एंड व्हाट आर द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द अनबैलेंस फोर्स? अनबैलेंस फोर्स कैन चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ रेस्ट पोजिशन शेप एंड साइज. एंड व्हेन इन द सेकंड सिचुएशन व्हेन वी आर जस्ट अप्लाइंग अ ग्रेटर अमाउंट ऑफ द फोर्स फ्रॉम वन साइड, व्हाट हैपेंस? वी आर जस्ट एबल टू मूव द रूप, वी आर जस्ट एबल टू चेंज द पोजिशन ऑफ द रूप, राइट. So that are the effects of the balanced and unbalanced forces. So for the example purpose, you have to just remember these points. Balanced force will not able to move the position of the object, will not able to change the position of the object, right? And unbalanced force will be able to change the position of the object, right? So these all things are all about of the balanced and the unbalanced force. Now children, after balanced and the unbalanced force, now we are just going to study, we are just moving forward to the next topic. So when we are talking about the force, so Newton's conclusions from the experiment of the some experiments, and to calculate the force, to give the definition of the force, he gives the three conclusions in the form of the laws, right? जब भी हमारे पास फोर्स का कॉन्सेप्ट आया था, उसके बाद आपके पास डिफरेंट एक्सपेरिमेंट्स की हेल्प से जो न्यूटन साइंटिस्ट थे, उन्होंने क्या करा था, सारे एक्सपेरिमेंट्स को कंक्लूड करके थ्री कंक्लूशंस को फाइंड आउट किया था, और उन थ्री कंक्लूशंस की हेल्प से वी आर एबल टू नो एवरीथिंग अबाउट द फोर्स. और वो जो तीन फोर्सेस होते हैं, वो जो तीन आपके पास लॉज होते हैं, उन थ्री लॉज की हेल्प से वी आर एबल टू नो एवरीथिंग अबाउट द फोर्स. हमें हर चीज़ पता होती है फोर्स के बारे में. सो व्हेन न्यूटन गिव्स द थ्री कंक्लूशंस, सो दैट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द थ्री लॉज. बट ये फर्स्ट कंक्लूजन, फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन, सेकेंड कंक्लूजन सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, एंड थर्ड कंक्लूजन थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. And we can say first law gives us the definition of the force. First law gives us the definition of the force, right? With the help of the second law, आपने second law की हेल्प से क्या कैलकुलेट करा? The numerical value. If you are just applying the force, how will we calculate it? आप अगर किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट पर फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे हैं तो उसे हम कैलकुलेट कैसे करेंगे? तो with the help of the second law, we calculated the mathematical formula to calculate the amount. तो सेकेंड लॉ की हेल्प से हमने क्या करा था? मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मुलेशन किया था फोर्स के लिए. एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द थर्ड लॉ, देन सो दैट गिव्स अस, इफ वी अप्लाई द फोर्स ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट, व्हाट इज द रिएक्शन ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन अस, देन. तो थर्ड लॉ ने आपको क्या डिफाइन किया था? अगर आप किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट पे फोर्स अप्लाई कर रहे हैं तो उस ऑब्जेक्ट का रिएक्शन क्या होगा व्हेन एवर यू आर जस्ट अप्लाइंग द फोर्स ऑन दैट ऑब्जेक्ट, राइट स्टूडेंट्स? नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट. So now children, we will talk about the three laws of motion, Newton's laws of motion. So we are having three laws of Newton's. Very first law. Very first law is defined as the first law of motion, or it is named as the law of inertia also. Now what is inertia? Basically, this is the property, inherent property of an object to resist any change in its state. Right? That means, what does it mean? इसका मतलब क्या है? कोई भी जो ऑब्जेक्ट होता है उसमें एक ऐसी प्रॉपर्टी होती है, राइट? दैट प्रॉपर्टी, जो प्रॉपर्टी किसी भी चेंज का ऑब्जेक्ट की स्टेट में किसी भी चेंज का अपोज करती है, राइट? दैट मीन्स सपोज दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट द स्टेट ऑफ रेस्ट. सो इफ वी जस्ट वॉन्ट टू मूव दैट ऑब्जेक्ट, सो दैट प्रॉपर्टी will oppose that change in its state, right? तो वो जो property होगी वो क्या करेगी, जो हम ये इसकी position में change कर रहे हैं, जो भी हम changes कर रहे हैं object की position में, उसका oppose करेगी, right? So that property is defined as the inertia, right? So the inability of an object to change its state of rest or uniform motion is called inertia. So the inability, unwillingness, inability or we can say unwillingness of an object. Unwillingness of an object to change its state of rest or motion. To change its state of rest or motion is defined as inertia. Inertia totally depends on the mass. That means mass is directly proportional to inertia, or inertia is directly proportional to mass. That means greater is the mass, greater is the inertia. Lesser is the mass, lesser is the inertia. Right? That means we can just understand it by an example. If you are having a very light weighted object, अगर हमारे पास कोई भी light weighted object है, तो we are just easily able to move that object, है? तो हम क्या करेंगे? उस object को बहुत ही easily move करने में able होंगे, क्योंकि उस time पे जो उसका mass है, वो less है, that's why जो inertia applied होगी, वो भी कम होगी. But अगर हमारे पास कोई भी heavy stone है, तो हैवी स्टोन का मास ज़्यादा होगा. इफ मास इज ग्रेटर, इनर्शिया इज ग्रेटर. इनर्शिया ग्रेटर का मतलब है उतना ही ज़्यादा वो फोर्स, उतना ही ज़्यादा वो अपोज करेगा अपनी स्टेट में चेंज का. दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव टू अप्लाई अ ग्रेटर अमाउंट ऑफ द फोर्स. इसीलिए उस कंडीशन में हमें क्या करना होगा, मच मोर अमाउंट ऑफ द फोर्स अप्लाई करना होगा. ओनली इन दैट कंडीशन वी आर जस्ट एबल टू मूव दैट हैवी स्टोन. Right? So inertia totally depends on the mass of the object, or we can say inertia is directly proportional to the mass of the object. Greater is the mass, greater is the inertia. Lesser is the mass, lesser is the inertia. Then, now states ki classification according to the states of rest, motion and change in the direction, we just classify inertia in three types basically. Very first type is defined as the inertia of rest, second type is defined as the inertia of motion, and third type is defined as the inertia of direction. Then, what is inertia of rest? Inertia of rest, tendency to oppose any change in state of rest. Tendency to oppose any change in state of rest is defined as the inertia of rest. Then, तो inertia of rest क्या होता है? अगर कोई भी object rest में है, तो उस rest की position में change का oppose करने की जो tendency होगी, that is defined as the inertia of rest. Right? तो आपके पास क्या, what is the example for that? Example is the carpet is beaten. So, when we beat the carpet from the street, what happens? जो आपके पास rest position में जो आपके पास dust particle होते हैं, they will come out. And वो बाहर आ जाते हैं. They will not move with the that stick only. Right? So that's why they will come out and dust will come out. Carpet is beaten from the moving stick. Right? So inertia of rest, tendency to oppose any change in its state of rest. That is, carpet is beaten to remove the dust. That is example of the inertia of rest. Inertia of motion, tendency to oppose any change in its state of motion. Right? Tendency to oppose any change in its state of motion. जैसे inertia of rest में rest position में change का oppose होता है, वैसे ही inertia of motion में motion की जो position होती है, उसमें change का oppose होता है. Right? So, for the example, passenger falls forward when suddenly bus stops. तो आपके पास क्या होता है? जैसे ही suddenly bus stop होती है, तो passenger falls forward. So suddenly क्या होते हैं? Passenger falls forward direction में forward. Right? Inertia of direction, tendency to oppose any change in its state of motion. Right? So for example, when bus taken curve turn, जब भी कोई bus होती है वो curve turn लेती है, तो क्या होता है? What happens? Passenger falls away from the center of the curve road. तो हमेशा क्या होता है? जो passenger होते हैं वो center of जो curve होता है, जहाँ से जो bus होती है वो turn लेती है, उससे away fall होते हैं. That is the inertia of direction. Right? So, in very first law, we talked about the inertia. Inertia is the inability or unwillingness of any change in state of rest or position of an object. Right? It is the inherent property of the object to change its state of rest or motion. There are three types of the inertia: inertia of rest, then inertia of motion, and inertia of direction. Right? So this is all about the first law of motion. That's all for today. Thank you.